And we're back!
Penis.
There are more people here. I don't like the fact that I don't have an overlay to support everybody.
Haha.
Since you can't see, I like rolled my eyes into the back of my head and thought they wouldn't come back.
Yeah.
You thought I wouldn't say penis.
No, I just think it's so stupid.
It is. That's what's fun about it.
First it was a bit, and now they ask for it.
No one asked.
He says do it because he knows that you're just gonna do it anyway, so we might as well just like endorse it.
Pretty much.
I almost didn't.
See, she has me figured out.
I won't.
I'm glad the recording started with us talking about the, merits of saying penis at the beginning.
That's the best part, right?
It's basically just tradition at this point.
Essentially.
Maybe change it up with like a cock or a
Johnson.
I'll just not say it anymore.
I'm gonna expect you to. You're gonna need to come up with a new
entirely.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Well, I can't use ding because that's a secret dealings noise.
These things get old Ding-a-ling. After a while. Like spice it up a little.
You know how like YouTubers start up with like, "Hey, what's up, bro?
Hey, what's up, you guys? Welcome back to
like, hey, what's up,
back, you bodacious bitches."
I'll just start doing it like
top of the morning, laddies.
Oh God, please no.
What's bouncing, my bodacious bitches? How about that? Does that work?
That's a pretty good one. A pretty good one.
Some mommy milkers.
Get out of here.
That's the kind of reaction I live for.
All right.
Well, you all remember. Oh, Blitz, to answer your question, yes, you would have just kind of been following behind everyone.
Cool.
Yeah. I assume you watched last week's video to be all caught up.
We did.
By last week, I meant
video?
Like 2 months
ago. That's
like
last month.
Yeah.
I watched it.
Oh shit, where to start? Oh, first off, if you recall, Poppy managed to summon a demon last week. I'm gonna retcon that out because that was a stupid idea.
Okay, then what do I get?
Well,
I got a crit. What? You gotta give me something.
Yeah, what? Yeah, you got like 230s, I think. What were you trying to summon again?
She was attempting to summon something that she could be a god to.
Oh, that's really funny.
So you tried to summon a demon?
No, she didn't attempt to summon a demon. That's just what he decided. Yeah.
So why don't you tell me what
you summoned? Can
just be a dog? What?
Just a dog.
Why don't you tell me what you summoned?
I don't know. I just remember that I messaged and said that she's attempting to summon something that she can like have ultimate control over.
Alright, do you want something like a golem, a humanoid, or like an animal?
That's a good question.
Mm-hmm. That's why I asked it.
Give me a humanoid.
Okay. See. All right. You summon. Let me look up a picture. Cothea. Miscellaneous picks. This is what you summon. A little goblin.
Goblin?
Yep.
That thing is too cute for this side of me.
I fucking love goblins.
Yeah. This is what you get.
Okay.
Oh shit, it's one of my fellas here. What's going on, buddy?
Music doesn't fit right now. Yeah, it kind of just looks very confused around and just like looking at you for guidance.
Alright, I'm gonna look really smug because it worked. And I will look down at this thing. Do I know what this is?
Yeah, you recognize goblin. They're common creatures.
Just making sure, I don't want to assume. Yeah. Alright, I'll look down at this goblin and I'll say, kneel before your god.
Damn it, I should have summoned one of those little fish people. I can't remember what they're called.
Murlocs?
Kuatoa?
No, the thing Tisha said. Something Toa. Kuatoa, yeah. It looks confused, but, you know, kneels. It kneels like a little knight.
Yes. Okay, I'll play along. Do I have... Let me look at my equipment really quick.
The rest of you.
Staff? Cool, I got staff. I'm gonna knight it. Basically tell it that it's like my first disciple.
If I recall correctly, it was... Who was with you?
The person that was with her
was just Cheese, and then we were going after her.
Yeah, but there was someone with her, I think, wasn't there?
No, they were just following behind.
We were following.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, Lukia, you're seeing this.
Oh, great.
And what do you say, Jordan?
I'm knighting it. I'm saying it's my first disciple, and that it should spread the word of...
Spread the word of me.
It looks very confused about what's going on, but also really proud.
He's like, oh my god, I'm the first disciple.
What should I be? What should my goddess title be?
Zaramel. The ever knowledgeable. The all-seeing eye.
Okay, I'll say... Carmel,
the flower of destiny!
No, I'm trying to stay away from, like, you know, domains that are already a thing. Don't want to offend anyone, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm sure calling yourself a god isn't going to offend
I just did, like, a moment ago.
Okay, I'll tell it that it should spread the word of the like a new up-and-coming god named Zaramel, the Eternal. Yes.
The Absolute.
No. Maybe. Maybe.
I'll be spreading the word of Mrs. Zaramel.
Mel. Zaramel.
Zaramel.
Sorry, smelly.
It looks very confused, but also like what am I doing wrong?
I'll take out like a piece of paper and my ink and whatever, and I'll just like write my name down phonetically.
Show it to him.
Yes,
it's a her actually. Stares down at it like I can't read.
It's a pretty big problem with amongst the goblin community, literacy.
Do I have a spell? I don't think I have a spell.
Sorry, missus.
I'm sorry, mistress. I just can't do it.
I'll just say that it should, like, if... I should just pass that to somebody. Keep it so you can hand it to, you know, like more people on your quest and your journeys.
All right.
it like nods its head really fast and its like ears are flopping around.
Cute. I will pat its head.
It looks like it just, it's got the biggest reward.
And I've got some gold, so I'll go ahead and give it like 10 gold. I'll give her 10 gold. And that will be, yeah.
I've never seen so much money in my life.
Go to your bidding. My bidding.
Alright. It nods his head. It's like, right, Mrs. Army. And it runs off towards the city.
Ah.
Because if I recall correctly, you went outside the city to a field.
Yes. Yes.
Make an intelligence check for me.
Okay.
Oh no.
Alright. A goblin with the weapon running towards the city, probably not going to end well for the goblin.
Okay, I'll chase after it. I don't think it'll take me very long. My legs are much...
No, it's very slow.
Yeah, and I'll say, for your own protection, since I value all of my disciples' lives, how about you go the other way?
Okay, which way?
I'll, like, point in the opposite direction. I don't know.
You just, like, point towards, let me pull out.
The wilderness.
I believe, the land, Amazia, the land of Turin, is a lot like, shit, what's, Sumero. Thor's the only one that gets that.
Okay. I just want it to go to, like, small places where it won't get hurt. Like, I do care about it. I don't want it to die or get,
yeah, I get it.
Wounded.
I'm just trying to... Yeah, you're in the Kingdom Galva. Sorry. I'm very in touch with all of my... shit.
Lore.
We can tell.
I heard.
Yeah, it's a desert-like landscape, but also has forests and shit. So a lot like Sumeru. For your information, Jordan. Do you send her towards a more forested area or the desert region?
Forest, I think that will be safer.
Okay.
There's more options for, like, water and things like that.
Okay. So you send them off.
Yes.
With your intelligence check, would you like to get their name first?
Sure.
Yeah. Why did I ask that? How about a name generator?
You can just tell me later.
Wayfish.
Gibble.
Wayfish?
Wayfish?
Wayfish.
Wayfish.
Yeah, end message. Wayfish.
The fish of way.
Fish of woe.
Gil Gillerson, fish woe.
Alright, if you look in miscellaneous picks, it's been updated. Alright, it trots on off. As you're watching it proudly, you hear from behind you, what the hell was that? And you turn around and there stands Xenox with the rest of the guys.
Ah. Okay. I will clasp my hands together as I, like, turn around and whip my luxurious red hair. I'll smile. Kind of like one of those not all there kind of smiles. Like, it's a bit unsettling. Like, she doesn't know how to do it. She's just trying. And she'll say, I've sent my first disciple to go spread the word about my new godhood.
And I just shake in my head in the back. Just a little, just like, I don't know, man, I don't know.
So you're the other god.
Did she dye her hair? Did her brains go out with her hair color?
Yeah, I kind of look between, Senex kind of looks between, Lucia and Poppy, and then he goes, Poppy? Question mark?
Question mark. Audibly.
Who was it?
No, audibly not question mark.
Was it Elyon? Elyon was the one that Mama told me about. Elyon. Yeah, there you go. Elon.
Musk?
Elyon Musk.
Yeah.
Elyon Musk. Oh, yeah, that entrepreneur fella. It'll never catch on.
As when she says like her like new goddess or new god whatever, it's like, so I kind of walk up. It's like, so you're the one that my mom was talking about with the child of Elyon, right?
It does please me to know that other people are already speaking about my most fantastical existence.
We get to be god buddies. I'm
you
also
get to
a
be
god.
What?
God buddies. What? Oh, yeah, you hear the news?
Thalia,
no!
Oh, for the love of...
Yeah. I'm a god.
You...
I'm a big deal.
What the fuck?
Don't take this the wrong way, but I don't believe you.
I don't believe you either.
I don't believe
me. It's fine for you not to believe me. I'll just have to prove it in another way. Should I summon another disciple, or...
Oh, no!
Better yet, I could just break your mind.
No, don't, no.
In my defense, that is going to be too easy for you to do. I'm not very book smart.
Punched the head.
You could do it. You can hear Xenox like audibly blinking. Just like the gears are turning. First off, and he kind of looks to you. Celia, I believe the term you're looking for is demigod. Which is hard to believe, but hard to believe anyone procreated to make you.
You're just jealous because I'm a demigod. Sucks to suck.
What can I say except you're welcome?
Seems unlikely. Demigods are very rare. Two being together? That's a stretch.
Maybe it's god fate. Maybe gods bring other gods together.
That's an out of a game joke for you guys.
I didn't get it.
You're all demigods.
Oh.
I don't believe that for a second.
I'll walk up closer to Xenox and I will pat his shoulder. But, I think I'm too short. I can't reach it. So, wherever that area is, wherever I reach. And I'll say, Senny boy, it's okay. For real. I might be a demigod now, but I'll just ascend to real godhood soon. This little book in my head. I have all the answers I need.
And Lucia, is that even possible?
I don't know.
Would one of those answers describe why you look like this?
Yeah, why'd you get a hairdo?
I don't know if I like it or not.
Her eyes are different colors.
Yeah, I know. Hair.
Well, the hair's easy, or eyes are easy to do. Hair's a little bit more, you know. I've seen people change their eye colors.
Not without something really, really powerful to do that.
I think it's a common cantrip. What was it? Thaumaturgy? No.
Yes.
It's not just her appearance. She's acting different as well.
I don't have all day to waste trying to explain why things are the way they are.
Right.
Any Xenox few moments.
Pick you up under your armpits and says, you need to explain now.
Was not expecting to see that side of you two today.
Bare teeth? Just growling?
Yes, I'm growling.
Oh. Xenox looks extremely unimpressed.
Okay, growling is definitely a lot more weird than what she was doing before.
Okay, I'll say, you're very lucky she told me I'm not allowed to mess with you, Senny boy, otherwise I would! Put me down!
Make an intimidation check.
Oh, God. That's going to go well.
Oh.
That went well.
Huh.
Yeah, I know.
No?
I said, yeah, I know. To her, huh?
No, I'm agreeing with the huh. I'm like, huh?
I don't know. Something about the way Poppy is acting right now really throws him off, and he puts you down, which is, you're still Poppy, so like, kind of seeing that expression on Satnox is not a good feeling.
Okay, I'll cross my arms. Rats, why are you acting like that? I don't like it. Stop it!
I'm confused.
She's gonna blame me for this now, too.
Who's she?
Poppy, of course! Who else?
You're Poppy!
No, I'm not. I'm Zaramel.
You just explained what's going on for me.
Poppy is sleeping right now. She lost the game. Now I get to play. I'm always stuck in there. Always so alone and boring, and it's so drab! And you're wasting my time! Any moment now she could wake up and suddenly I'll just be gone, wasting, rotting away up in that little head. And I really don't want to go back yet.
Wait, there's two of you living in there? Is it like a condo? Do condos exist here?
That was two coasts ago, actually.
What's everyone's passive perception?
13!
No. 11.
15.
16.
For those of you with 15 or higher...
Damn it.
You start to hear what sounds like screaming. Getting louder.
Where? Getting louder towards, like, is it, like, louder in a distance? Is, like, more screaming? Or, like, screaming coming towards us? Is it a group of screams? A single scream? It
seems to be a single female scream.
As what, coming from where?
Outside the town, inside the town.
Upside town?
Okay, I'm going to swiftly turn around. I'm going to march toward that direction, and I'll say, finally, something interesting to break apart matter by matter!
My god!
The screaming seems to be coming from above you.
Above? What?
Yeah, you look up, and there is a woman falling from the sky.
Oh shit!
Cool. Can I make the water into like a little pool?
The water?
Yeah.
What water? You're on a field.
Is it raining?
It's raining. I heard thunder.
I hear thunder and lightning.
Nope, that is just the character's theme.
Oh.
Law, you are falling.
Ignore
from the
that.
Sky.
I didn't mean to click that. Please.
And she's at the tangent for some reason.
Oh shit!
So like 2 feet before I either crash into you or into the ground, I cast Featherfall.
Probably try to catch you.
I was gonna say I'm already trying to do that.
Yeah,
we're kind of stooging it up here.
So threw me up. Throw me from the ground before she splats. She casts Featherfall and her momentum slows down immensely.
You slowly fall into my hands.
I use Gust to just maneuver myself out of trajectory of falling into someone's hand and just land on the ground.
You blast Gust and I just fall flat on my ass.
It's like a heart in your face.
And let me stand up and brush myself off. I am so incredibly sorry about that.
How am I the only one on the floor after that?
Huh? I lost track of time.
Doing what?
I was flying.
That wasn't flying. Oh. That was falling.
With style.
Falling with style.
spell ran out, and I just lost track of time. Might have drifted asleep at the wheel a little bit, but it's fine.
So what you're trying to say is you're careless with your magic? Unimpressive.
I mean,
how did you get up in the air?
I was flying.
Redhead poppies.
I can fly.
So, for context,
magic is a pain in the ass.
You were flying towards the city of Valstead, because, it was the next city over. And you just kind of lost track of time, like how long your spell lasted.
Yeah. And now that, Glaw is standing up, or it's Glaw, I keep in my head.
Nerx does that.
Yes. And, she has pale blue skin, and wild gray hair that kind of looks like the color of a storm cloud. And at first you think they're scars, but it's actually fissures through her skin of what looks like lightning bolt scars. And it's kind of like how when glaciers crack, the blue gets deeper as it goes in, a deeper blue as the crack goes further in. It's kind of that kind of vibe.
Do you have a picture for this character?
I have a pit crew, but I have not drawn her yet.
Oh.
I will
post it. I am more than likely going to end up giving you fan art here before too long.
I do plenty of my own cheese skin.
Yeah, oh, so good.
Can you post what you have in Cothea PC pics? Or Cothea PC?
This was my long con to get more artists in the group.
Oh!
And her eyes are very weird, because the sclera is black, and then the iris is a very vibrant blue, and the pupil is white. So it's inverted.
Huh.
And she's wearing a very deep cut sleeveless shirt with a fine silk scarf wrapped around her waist. And then just normal working kind of pants and cuffed boots.
Huh.
And she has a necklace that has a weird liquid in it.
Who doesn't care around weird liquids, am I right?
Yeah.
I don't.
I'm gonna
I always carry around weird liquid.
Handstand or back. What the fuck is it called?
When you back handspring?
Back handspring? Is that what it is? Yeah.
Back handspring or kip up.
Mm hmm. Ah. So, why'd you drop in? What you flying to?
I was heading towards the city. I don't come here often. This is the longest I've been on land. So I'm a little out of sorts.
Are you usually not on land?
No, I had a ship.
Oh. Yeah. I lean over to. Is Nakina? Is it? It's Nakina.
It is. Good job.
I did it. Is Nakina with us?
Yeah. Okay. Throughout the entire last thing, she was just aimlessly following you guys around.
Just there. I lean over to Nakina and I go, "I thought that she was flying the whole time."
I have no idea. I don't. Does the poppy?
Do I hear that? Poppy, do I hear that?
Woman's falling. I don't know what's happening.
16.
What were you saying, cheese?
I thought that the Glau? Glau was flying the whole time.
I guess. Yeah, with 16, yeah, you would hear it.
Okay. I will
loud whisper.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'll like roll my eyes and I'll just say every spell has a duration, Lucia.
Uh-oh.
So, yeah, I'm glad somebody said it because I was completely lost.
Like delivering some cargo or something?
We did a little bit of everything. It was mostly working for merchants.
Mm, I know that feeling.
A kindred spirit. Well, good luck. I guess. I mean, I don't know.
Yes, exactly. I'm quite done with this conversation. I'm going to turn back to.
Is that a goblin in the distance?
I'm going to turn back to Senox and I'm going to like ghost my hand near his because I'm not allowed to touch it. And I'll say, I'd like to go try this thing here. I believe Poppy said it was like cotton candy. I'd like to see if I can make it myself. Will you come, please?
Senox, who is thrown off by this new poppy, but also is like, I can't leave this thing alone. And he's like, I guess so.
Don't do anything I wouldn't.
Aren't you a virgin?
Oh, no.
He exchanges a skeptical look with Poppy.
They walk off. Shit-eating grin.
Is she trying to find candy floss?
Yeah.
Oh. It's not that good.
She said she was going to try to make it.
No, she said floss. She wanted to make it.
Oh.
Something strange is happening to Poppy.
Something strange is happening all around us. Poppy is not Poppy. People are falling from the sky. They just walked off to go make cotton candy. What?
Yeah, I'm aware.
In the world
is that a euphemism?
It's happening right now.
No, it's not.
Let's not just like think through literally any of them walking away, and let's backtrack to the person falling from the sky.
If it makes anything better, I fall out of the sky a lot.
I don't think that makes me feel any better, actually.
Miss Cloud, that is not. That does not.
That is.
Put really my mind at ease here.
Oh. Okay.
I mean, she didn't hit the ground.
Yeah, I mean, I've never.
This time.
I've never crashed.
I find that hard to believe.
I really doubt it.
Okay. Air. Crashed it in air. I've crashed once at sea. But on land, I've never crashed.
This is just making it more confusing. Guys.
That's what my aunt
says. The big dumb idiot here is scratching his head like, oh, God, I can't think straight now.
Anyway, you're here. Hi.
Hi. I never caught any of your names.
I'm Nakina.
Nakina. Okay.
Uh-huh.
I'm Lucia. Hi.
Hello.
I'm Thelia, the god.
You're not a god.
Oh,
god.
I'm a god.
She's not a god.
Ignore literally anything that comes out of them about being a god. We're just skipping over that. There's so much happening, Thelia.
It's heresy, Thelia.
Right now. We cannot deal with this right now.
It's heresy. I'm a god.
Oh, it's heresy, Thelia.
What kind of god are you?
Oh, don't encourage her. Don't encourage her.
No.
I mean,
I'm a god of nature, so like anything
you're not.
That happens kind of just happens.
Don't pick a fight on if they are or aren't. Let's just move on from the conversation so we can move forward in what we were doing.
I can't do this.
Fair enough. I am Mildred the very confused right now. Thank you.
Hi, Mildred. I'm also a god.
I pick up Thalia and I chuck her.
So you said you're a pirate? A sailor?
Sailor, yeah.
Of the skies?
Are you sure pirate sounds cooler?
Mm-hmm. I mean, technically we're privateers.
So pirates.
Mercenary, technically, here. So.
Mercenaries,
break the law. Everything we do is legal.
Exactly,
exactly. Pirate the pirates.
I can't condone law breaking. As a holy woman. Can.
You're fine. Get over it.
You. She's a privateer,
yes,
therefore it's on the up and up.
That's fine. But.
So, like, her crew would help my crew at sea.
Yeah.
Like, protect us from other pirates.
Yeah.
Ideally.
We're bodyguards, basically, kind of. Mm-hmm. But I was the navigator, so I didn't, like, do too much. I'm good with wind and stuff. And so my aunt had me in charge of navigation. My captain.
Family business, then.
Yeah.
Glau.
Rhymes with now.
Glau and Thalia. You two feel a sort of connection with each other.
Oh, shit.
Kind of hard to pinpoint what it is.
It's because we're sailing buddies.
Are we sailing buddies?
You probably worked at least with us at one point.
That's cool. A bit.
I've been on a boat all my life, so.
Me too. Like, my aunt and my dad worked on the boat. And then when I was given to my dad, he gave me to my aunt. And then I went on her boat.
Oh, I never met my dad. I think he's probably dead or something. I don't know. My mom's a god.
Mine is too.
How did you get back here?
Too?
What? And you just know that?
Yeah.
You just like have that. I'm not questioning it. You two are gods. Got it.
I mean, when I can do this,
I'm done. I'm done.
Obvious.
I'm with. Nakina. I'm with Nakina at this point. We're walking away. Like, oh, this is.
I'm going to
just accept it. It's easiest to just accept it.
I accept nothing. I'm just going to ignore it and hope it goes away.
I'm going to cast Mage Armor on myself, and as I do, I like start to float off the ground, and like the scars like start to glow like lightning, and I say. It's kind of common knowledge on my ship. I'm not normal.
I'm just a little concerned, you know?
About what?
Just everything in general.
So who's your mom? Which one?
Zaris? I don't know how to pronounce it. I've only been reading it.
Zaris. Zarisis?
Have you, like, known her for a while? Did you, like, just meet her? My curiosity
siblings?
Has now been piqued.
I've never,
half-sisters.
Half-sisters.
Oh, shit.
I've never, like...
My ears are burning right now. I'm like, oh, no, something happened. Something has happened. Akina, we need to prepare for a DEFCON 3.
My problem is that my curiosity has now been piqued by her knowing her mom, and I want all of the answers. You are on your own now.
I met my mom.
That is the first time
ago.
Anybody's called me Nil.
Oh, not met my mom. I saw my mom an hour ago.
Wait, do we know each other well enough for you to be calling me Nil?
Oh, that's a cute nickname.
Me?
Yeah.
I didn't say no.
I thought you said no.
It's probably cut off.
I said you're on your own now.
Now, okay. Damn. I was hoping somebody would give him that. I was hoping that I got a nickname from that. Fine.
Well, now I'm gonna use it. So you got a nickname. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry. All right.
I'm getting away from the.
His eye was twitching.
I'm getting away. from this confusion, I'm just going to go see to the horses at this point.
So, are we leaving? Is it time?
No, but I'm going to go pay the people who look after them.
Happening.
I mean, two of you were given quests to leave the city, so. Jeez, you were one of them.
Yeah, I do have to. I do have a quest to leave the city.
Well, I have a new quest now.
No.
That current quest is now to ask my new found half sister everything about her boating adventure.
Oh, I mean, I'll tell you what I can remember.
Chaos.
Oh wait, you said you were delivering something, right? We can at least help with that.
I haven't had a shipment in many months. Mainly because I haven't had a ship.
Oh. So what's you heading to the city for?
I've just been looking, investigating, because my ship disappeared.
Disappeared? Like,
just
a portal? Did they dock and leave?
We were at sea, and I got knocked off. And then there was just no evidence of it existing anymore.
Like no paperwork?
Well, like, people know the Dark Horizon, but I can't find it. And I can't find any of the crew.
Huh.
Like, why did you get knocked off? Because of like a fight? Was it the wind? Was it rough waves?
I got struck by lightning.
You got struck by lightning.
And got blasted off.
Your was story it, just gets more and more concerning.
That's what happened here. And I point to the scars. These are new.
They don't look that new.
I mean, it's been a couple months. I wasn't born with them.
Oh.
Been cool, though.
You guys are about 220 miles from the nearest port. Just a note.
So you got struck by lightning, fell off a boat. Typically when a boat hits lightning, yeah. Sort of damage.
The boat didn't get hit by lightning.
You got hit by lightning.
I got hit by lightning.
You just took while the you were on a boat. Of the lightning onto
while
the face.
I was on a boat. It was to the chest. That's what chest. Most of, yeah.
So you just absorbed the shock of the blow, and like you saved the boat pretty much. Did someone throw you into it?
No.
Just like a single strike, and then just boom.
And it was kind of like a lightning rod type of situation, I think. There wasn't a lot of people on deck because it was like really bad. There was like 20-foot swells and stuff, so most people were below deck. But I was like, I was a good luck charm, so I always tried to like stay on top to help control things. And then it just happened, and I woke up on the shore, and that's it. But yeah, I can't find anything that suggests that my ship is still operating or that it was destroyed.
Have I heard anything about said ship within any recent times?
You have
Sir
not.
God? I have not.
Yeah, you come from two different countries.
Yeah.
So, fortunately, you would not.
I haven't heard anything about no lost boats recently, or about your crew anytime recently. So, and I left mine a few months ago. So,
yeah.
Well, let's find them. Did you have some clues in the city around here? I mean, we're pretty far from a port, so.
I've At this point, I've just been looking for people, not necessarily a ship. Because, honestly, the ship isn't the important part.
It was the people on the ship.
Yeah. Specifically, my aunt. She was the captain.
What's her name?
I'll have to find it real quick, because I changed it. Marion.
Marion. I haven't heard anything about a Marion either.
And my dad's name is Darren. I don't know if
Marion and Darren.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, just had to get that one out of the way.
Ooh.
So did you, like, have a lead leading towards here, or just kind of, like, searching every city you can find?
I've just been going city to city. I don't currently have any leads. Which, I mean, honestly, probably is why I haven't had any luck. I'm not good at, like, this. She gestures at, like, herself.
Okay. Context. Well, we're about to head out to, what was that place again? What the fuck was I told to go?
Nope.
Well, I was told to go somewhere. Yeah, I got a name for it. I don't remember.
Well, I know where I need to go. It's definitely written down somewhere. Tormelos.
Hmm. Was that it? Did I write that down?
That is where you...
Yes, there was a man trapped in his head in Tormelos. Yes.
Why are you going for Tremelo's cheese?
I was told in a vision.
Did you?
That I'm running out of time. I'm seeking the prophet of destiny.
There you go.
That's me.
I wrote my shit down.
Well, if you need an extra set of hands, I can probably find someone.
Like?
That's a joke, because...
Yeah,
my hands are useless.
She pulls out.
Oh, and that you can't find your crew.
Yeah.
Well, I already got my own extra set of hands, and as I say that, I like activate my astral arms, and my as I wave my arm, like my whole arm, it starts to echo. You see, like traces of other arms behind them.
Whoa!
Oh, yeah. In case you didn't know,
hands on me.
Delia's a demigod. In case you didn't hear that.
I got hands for days.
I think we talked about that.
So, not enough, though.
I know.
Sorry. Hands for days.
I have a half sister, which I have to unpack.
My mom
that.
Did say she got around.
Oh my but god!
The
see, you spell ozone for some reason.
Ozone?
Yeah. Like lightning in the air.
Sky. I look up. Are there storms like forming?
Nope.
I have flashbacks.
I back away slightly from Gaul. I was like,
the smell persists for you and you alone.
Yeah, I'll go away. So yeah, you want to head to Tremel's with us? After we, like, have you been to, what's the current city that we're at right now?
Valstead.
I have no idea where. Valstead. Valstead. Have you checked out Valstead for your pa and aunt?
Not yet. I was heading there.
We can do a check there, and then if nothing turns up, we can head to Tremel's and see if there's anything there.
Yeah. Sounds like a deal.
Cool. Let's go then.
You can leave Zaramel, I guess, and Senox to deal with their own cotton candy situation.
Are we not worried about that? I'm worried about that.
I don't know how to fix it, to be honest, so I'm gonna not worry about it.
I mean, Senox is with her.
She says she has two people inside her head. I mean, there's nothing I can do about that.
I mean, the guy's a bastard, but I trust him with her. You know?
I mean, kind of have to.
I feel like they'll be
okay. I know I'm missing something, but I'm almost too afraid to ask because this seems very complicated.
You'll probably meet them later. Day. It's fine. Off back to the city. Back to town.
Yeah, okay. Let's go.
Valstead.
Awesome. Cool. So, this is great. Wow. Come on, everybody.
Yikes.
While they're guiding you through the city, Glau, you'll notice that when you first step into the city, it's kind of a shithole. The whole section that you're in just seems like slums. But then you start to ascend the city, and it gets a little nicer. Things are more like what an average town would be. You know, you stop there, but you can see further up and in, the city gets nicer the higher you go.
So the higher in the air they get, the nicer it is.
Correct.
I like that.
You know, shit tends to flow downhill.
Yeah. Trickle down. Shitonomics.
Yay, trickle down!
Seems to be like a 5-tier city.
Personally, I love trickle-down economics.
If it works.
It doesn't.
Currently, it's not.
Let's not think about that.
All right, let's get out of that. It's too real.
Let's head to just the first random tavern we can see and check like any wanted or like missing boards or wanted boards or any people. Did you like put out any notice of a missing crew or anything like that, or just been searching on your own?
I've just been searching. Yeah, I don't know necessarily where I fell off. And I don't know if like they qualify as missing. I think I'm the one that's missing.
Oh, so we should look for any missing persons of you on it.
I think that's also a good like method. I've been doing both, I think.
So you guys head to the tavern where you're all staying at. You check like the bounty board, whatever they call it in
video Craigslist.
Games. Yeah.
Yeah.
Craig is the barkeep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No mention of you or your family, Glau.
Okay.
You do see in one of the back corners at a table, Javi, why don't you go ahead and describe your handy cotton candy making process here?
Sweet, merciful gods. No.
How did she make it to how did she get here before? Didn't she like walk the other way?
Jordan?
I feel like we're just not questioning anything, so let's just accept it.
Do you theirs, Jordan?
Who said my name?
Yeah, I did. I asked Poppy to describe her cotton candy making process.
Oh, well, I need an example first. I don't know anything of what it looks like.
I think I know how to make cotton candy.
I need an example of, like, I need the item in front of me.
Do you know what a cotton candy machine looks like?
Oh my gosh. I'm talking about cotton candy. I need to find a stall with cotton candy so I can attempt.
Yeah, you would have got some and came back to the tavern. That's what I'm saying.
Okay. Then I'm going to look at
the
It's fine. It's fine. Well, I'm going to need to see what it's made out of, which, thankfully, I can do that. Um,
He's got like a bunch of random bags of flavored sugar.
Yeah, just a big feel free fucking... to make that shit up on your own, because I don't know what cotton candy is made out of. Sugar.
Yeah, it's just it's flavored sugar. Got a big old tub thing that heats it up in the middle, and then it spins real fast and shoots out the sugar in like small strands. That's a messy fucking process.
Yep.
If you fuck
so,
it up.
So I'm gonna attempt to. Did I get the necessary ingredients, or am I going to reuse ingredients?
Yeah, you could mark off ingredients. Mark off a gold.
Okay.
Sugar's expensive.
Right, so I'm going to take this sugar, and I am going to ask the innkeeper if they have, like, are fans a thing in this world?
No.
Not even like rudimentary ones?
No.
Okay. I need a means of creating air. I'm going to tell Senox to blow on it. Like, a lot.
He gives you a long hard stare and just says, no.
Stomp my foot.
No, little rabbit.
Okay, what can I do?
Just fucking across the fucking tavern.
Only you had some kind of magic to make air.
Trans name again.
Yeah, I don't have that. Unless you're talking about somebody else, but I don't think they're back yet.
No, this is just Senox talking to Puffy.
Well, can you make air?
I'm not the one claiming to be a god.
And every god has a weakness. That's quite rude. Aren't you supposed to be in love with me?
Aren't you supposed to be all sweet?
Well, isn't there a side to everyone that you don't want other people to know about?
Right back at
first they're
you.
Sour, then they're sweet. Sour Patch Kids. Yeah, that's just basically what you are.
You can tell he's taking great joy in bugging you right now.
I can't just create air. Can't just do that. So, not even with my altering atoms, it's just not possible. So
why don't you blow on it?
Hey, yo, Poppy! I got an air maker here. As I put my hands out in like a very presenting manner towards Gaul. Gale.
Glau.
Gaul. Glau. There you go. Glau. Glau. Like glamour. Okay.
Your name isn't pronounced the way it's spelled here, and neither is hers.
Mine is.
I feel like,
it's Welsh.
I feel like Green is real dumb and forgets how to pronounce names, then he tries to play it off like he's doing it on purpose.
Like
no,
it's a bit.
I literally am not good with names. I always forget them. It's a genuine thing. I always say, if I say it wrong, I'll just say, yep, that's how I say it now. That's why you hear me fucking up. Like, when I fuck up Brentwood and with, like, Bentwood and shit like that, it's sometimes that's me messing with it, but I generally forget his name.
I get it.
It's cool.
You hooligan.
Hey, I have bad memory. Don't blame me. Blame my genetics. I'm just built bad.
You're just built different.
No, built better.
Do you need wind?
Yes, I do.
Okay. And she walks over, cracks her fingers, her knuckles, rubs her hands together, and then just starts blowing air in your face. I don't know what you want me to do.
I'll point to the sugar.
Oh! Blow it on the
your
sugar.
Beautiful hair is now a mess from the air.
I'm busy with a task right now. I don't care. I'm attempting to create something, and that is way more entertaining.
Culinary magic.
All right, so whenever she starts blowing in at the sugar, I'm gonna make the you know, the fucking particles in the air, I'm gonna make a bounce and do shit together and get hot, you know, make the air hot. And then I'm gonna take the little stick I got and I'm gonna like start running in a circle just in there trying to make the little cotton candy thing that I had.
I need each of you to make dexterity checks.
All of us?
No, just the Blau and Zara.
Okay.
There's a nat 20. Let's hear the nat 1. The dichotomies.
Oh,
there's a one there.
But... Oh no! How do I turn off advantage?
Oh, you toggle it. You go to the settings next to spells on the right. There's gonna be a little cogwheel.
Yep. Oh.
Roll inquiries is advantage toggle. Whisper to GM and whisper toggle.
This feels oddly familiar.
You can
familiar.
Either auto roll damage or auto roll damage.
Okay. And then I'll do it again. Oh.
Yeah. Oh, don't worry. We'll take the 3.
Okay.
The one on the left is the first roll, so.
Okay.
Poppy, it's going great.
Yeah.
You are perfectly super heating this sugar.
Fantastic.
The stick is in the proper place.
Amazing.
Yeah. Unfortunately, the air being blown about just fucks it all up, and superheated sugar is thrown over everyone.
Everyone?
Yeah, everyone, because you were all crowded around the stable watching.
The stable? Great. I thought this was the pub!
Yeah. Oh, except for Josh.
I'm in the stables.
So, so do I have heated sugar on me?
Yeah, all of you do. It's
it burns. I'm melting.
Yeah, that's that. Heated sugar is like one of the most dangerous.
Yeah,
definitely dangerous.
Luckily, you all have the durability of demigods.
So it's dangerously delicious.
Not life-threatening.
Dangerously delicious! I love it!
Poppy, as you're sitting there, kind of blinking at what happened, you hear... My mic's not picking up my slow clap. But you hear a slow clap, and you look over at Senox just fucking... clapping.
So...
Okay. Fine. I don't have anything for this. Okay, never mind. I'd like to kick his chair out from under him. Please.
Make a strength check.
Oh god, never mind.
Athletics.
Athletics?
Yeah.
This can only end well.
Oh, it's my double-clicking mouse.
Yeah, that's fine. You kick his chair as hard as you can. Does not budge an inch, but now your foot really hurts.
And now I'm crying.
Yeah. You really underestimated just how fucking bulky Senox is.
No, like, she's actually crying.
Oh, the burns were too much. It hurts.
So nice. Just kind of a sigh and kind of pat your head and there.
Oh, why were we making cotton candy again?
She wanted to make cotton candy.
Why would you do that? I guess she's just gonna cry in the corner, okay.
Real.
Talking to you, Bobby.
Uh I hesitate to, like, let me message her.
Hmm?
I'm messaging you.
I love this. I love the messages.
Yeah, horses seem fine, Mildred.
Doesn't mean I'm not gonna help them stay nice and healthy.
Okay. Kill them.
I mean,
eat them.
I'm gonna try and. Fine. It's basically just me trying very, very hard not to go anywhere near the crazy at the moment.
That's fine, Jordan. But you know, you gotta tell them what they see.
She just looks really. Like, really sad. I don't know how to explain it. It's like she's furious, but she's sad. So you know when, like, kids, like, drop their ice cream or whatever, and they've had, like, the shittiest day ever? So, like, they're crying, but their face is so red because they're just, like, angry at the world? Like, that's how she is acting
right
now.
God came down and slapped the ice cream out of their hands?
Yeah.
I want to use prestidigitation to, like, reset everything that I just screwed up on her. Like, her hair, all the melted sugar. Just clean everything up.
Samus would kind of just sigh and says, do we have anything on the agenda to do?
Well, we were looking for my new sis for her aunt and her dad. Kind of searching around here a bit before heading off to. Oh God, what's it called again? Tormelos. There you go, like that video game.
Also, because I had a vision, and it says I'm running out of time, Celia. It very much does matter.
That's plenty of time.
We don't know how much time.
Plenty.
All right. How about we set out tomorrow? Sound good?
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. This one needs a nap, and he's going to pick Poppy up.
Someone put baby to bed.
Also, is that just like... I mean, she says there's two in there, so, like, is that, like, a child Poppy, and the other one's, like, older Poppy, or they're both, what's the, like, difference between the two of them? Right, why are there two?
Xenox is gonna pick up Poppy and start walking towards the room. He's gonna look at you, Thea, say, try to be less unlikable tomorrow.
Less unlikable?
Yeah.
Oof.
So, and at that point, he walks away. With Poppy in under his arms.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's fine, Josh.
What the hell's happened in here?
You don't even know.
Sugar disaster.
Even though she
also meet my sister.
Away the So Glau
Glau said that, at least as far as I was aware, just only said that she got rid of it on Poppy.
Yeah, let me finish speaking.
Okay.
I'm saying that you still have little red marks on your face from when the sugar burned.
Sick.
You know what? I'm kind of glad that I didn't follow you guys up here.
It's always the right choice.
It was fun until it wasn't.
I think it was still fun after.
I don't know. It was kind of fun to stand back and watch, honestly.
And the sugar tastes really good.
Yeah, I would not be licking that off of yourself, personally.
Why?
It just doesn't seem very sanitary.
But it tastes good.
That's great. I'm gonna go shower to get all of this out of my hair, though.
That's a question. Do showers exist in this fantasy land?
Yes.
I'm gonna go take a bath at least. Get out of my hair.
Both showers and baths like exist.
A bathhouse nearby? Imagine.
There is indeed a bathhouse nearby.
Nikina's just gonna walk off towards it. Not a huge fan of having sugar in her hair.
Oh, bathhouse adventures.
So for the sake of having a lot to do today, I'm gonna go ahead and skip to the next day.
Yay!
Alright.
Unless any of you have anything else you want to do today.
I am already sore from having fought you. So no. I'm good. I'll take
my
long rest.
But only if something happens.
All right, I've got the horses saddled up, or hitched up, the wagon's ready to go. He's pointing at Glau.
Yes.
Are you coming with us?
I can.
Of course she's coming with us. As I walk up and put my arm around your shoulder.
You two have been awfully chummy lately here, so I was just wondering.
I think they're half-sisters.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I guess we are.
You know
sister
what?
Sister from another... sister from the same mother.
Yeah.
But a different father. Yeah, okay, getcha.
Sisters from different misters.
Sister from a different mister.
Then hop aboard. I'll go ahead and get us moving then.
All right. So, real quick.
I take my spot on top of the carriage again.
Real quick.
Yes, sir.
Poppy. That's usual.
What?
Pay attention.
Don't read.
I'm not reading.
I know.
Poppy. You once more, and you are back to being good, Poppy. You once more find yourself in your old dorm room inside your head.
Oh.
The test continues. So, go ahead and make me another intelligence check. With advantage, sorry.
Okay.
Finish roll, my god.
Another 9.
DC is 10 for Christ's sake. Alright, so you sit down and just think it out for a while. About 30 minutes in, Dark Poppy kind of pops back in. And just kind of giving you a look like she hopes you fuck up again.
Great.
Yeah.
Well.
So you lose about 30 minutes of the hour that she gets. Go ahead and make me another check.
With advantage or no?
Yes. Finally. You think long and hard about it. You remember the clue she gave you that the only thing you need is yourself. And you think, it can't be that fucking stupid and easy, can it? And you say your name aloud. You say Poppy. And the door clicks open. And Dark Poppy just looks devastated and upset that you got it.
Stuck my tongue out at her.
Yeah. And do you walk out the door?
Yeah.
Okay. You wake up with Senox, back to your normal appearance and normal Poppy.
Do I wake up with a start, or, just, I'm awake now?
You're awake now. And if you tell me how you wake up.
Alright, well, if... Was I doing that test that whole time?
No. After the hour, you kind of just, went to,
After the hour, you basically were sitting in like a theater watching Dark Poppy.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so you saw everything that happened.
Then, yeah, I would be like, you know, like, what the fuck?
To note, you know how advantage on wisdom checks when dealing with a codex.
Thank fuck. I already have two of those really bad instabilities. I don't know what they do, but...
Who the hell yelled? What's going on?
I don't think I was that loud.
No.
No.
But I did yell, so, you know, the man of the hour next to me should be like, what?
He kind of looks up at you and says, did you say fuck?
Wait, wait, wait.
Oh, no. Please forget you ever heard me say that.
Absolutely.
I didn't say it.
You said it.
Oh no.
You're like, I need to contact the school.
Contact the clergy. He said fuck.
Hello? You rang?
I'm telling Lucia.
No, no, you can't tell her. Please, Senox.
They'll kind of ruffle your hair and say it's good to have you back.
I'll bury my head in like the crook of his shoulder. I'll be like, that was the worst test ever!
Is it because you failed the first time?
No, we don't talk about it. We're not going to talk about it. I don't fail things. You know that.
You know, like how you don't say fuck.
I don't.
She did.
It's just the after effects. Yeah.
He just kinda come on. We gotta go to some pumpkin town, apparently.
Will you carry me?
Get dressed.
Baby wants uppies.
Yeah, grabby arms.
He's gonna like throw your shirt in your face.
Okay. I will look up at him with, like, puppy dog eyes, and I'll say, if I get dressed, will you carry me?
Make a persuasion check.
Can I do it with advantage?
Nope.
Oh, it's a 16! It might not double click.
Yep.
Fine.
Yes!
Cool. Well done.
So.
Oh, and I must do my daily question for the codex.
Sure, go. Mecca, what is your question?
My question will be...
Will Senox give me up?
Hmm?
Will Senox give me up? Yes.
He already did. I won. I will ask the codex, I will ask it, where is Amelia? That's what I'll ask.
Where is Amelia?
Mm-hmm.
You get the equivalent of, like... It's like when you use a spell that just doesn't work. Like, it doesn't go through.
Ooh, faulty spell.
Which is odd to you. Because the codex should know everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
but doesn't seem to go through. It doesn't do the same thing that the codex usually does to you. You don't get that slight headache or nosebleed or other things. It just doesn't work.
Okay, then I'm going to ask it a second question just to see if it doesn't work again. Yeah. What should I ask it? Will Severance find me? I think I asked it that the last time, so. All right. It has a secondary response, then I'll know something is different.
Make a wisdom check.
I could with advantage. Yes. Ooh.
Severance already found you.
Well, you know what I meant.
Will they find you again?
Yeah, like, will they yes. hurt me?
You didn't ask them.
Then I'll ask it that. Jesus. I'll ask it that.
So you ask a third question.
Yes, I'll ask a fucking third question.
Make another wisdom check.
Jesus. Motherfucker.
Point number three, Jordan.
No! Yeah. Do I have a little moment again, or what?
You have a little moment, yes.
What is it?
Same as last time.
Nosebleed?
Just my nosebleed.
Slight trickle, yes.
So I'm just staring at nothing, thinking about how I could just destroy everything. Feels good.
As you're kind of just standing there, staring at nothing, contemplating, unraveling the atoms of the universe.
Yeah.
You are brought back to yourself when Xenox gives you a spank because you're taking too long to get ready.
Okay. I think because of the trance I'm in, I won't react the same way, but I will, like, turn around slightly and give him like one of those, like when dogs kind of like growl or whatever, and they're like, hey, don't that's my territory, stop it, like that would be her, but not intimidating or scary at all, just okay.
Keep that up and I'm not carrying you.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean it.
Be like at the front of the tavern in like a car honking a horn, like, get the fuck out here.
Eventually, you all meet up downstairs, a new member in tow, and you make your way to the outskirts of the city where the stables are kept. You hook up the horses to your bright pink carriage.
Seriously, who was the one that decided to put this as bright pink?
It was you, actually, Nildred, who said, I don't care which one, just pick one. And the seller took that opportunity to get rid of this horrid pink carriage.
On the bright side, it will never be stolen, and you'll always be able to find it.
And again, it hides the blood.
No, the blood shows up on it pretty badly.
This ain't Danganronpa, but blood is not pink.
All right.
5 points for anyone guess that reference.
I wasn't paying attention to that part.
It is technically monochrome, though.
Huh.
Don't talk back to the DM.
Who cares? All right. Get in the carriage.
Everybody get in.
I'll get
on. We wasted enough time waiting for those two to come down.
Yeah.
How's the dragon head?
I was just about to say, Cloud, you see a big-ass dragon head attached to the front of his carriage.
Oh, you guys have a...
Like, it's a skull, I should say.
Oh. My brain went to, like...
Taxidermied?
No, like, how ships have the...
Oh.
She knows the name for it. I don't know the name
Masthead.
It's a masthead. Yep.
And she's like, yes. That's a choice for a masthead.
Yeah. Killed it.
Not killed there. Ourselves.
Oh.
Ate it too.
Yep.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are we in the carriage yet, or are we?
Oh, yeah, you better be in the goddamn carriage. I'm taking it off without y'all.
Then I am in Senox's lap, and I'm going to clap my hands. I'm going to say, I never got to say hello yesterday. My, something was being rude.
I called a lollipop.
I'm sorry about the sugar. I hope I didn't hurt you.
Oh, I'm used to pain. It's okay.
I've never had to try to make cotton candy before.
So
evidently, neither have I.
So, Chelsea. If you look in...
Kelsey.
That's not your
I've
name.
I've been called Chelsea for 25 years. I'm immune to it.
Alright. Kelsey. If you look in Important Fix... Go get the perfect. You'll see Lollipop, who red hair, red eyes. That's who you saw yesterday. If you look in PCs, where you post your pick and scroll up, you'll see Zaramel Corbin. That's who you see now.
Oh. Okay.
Yep.
You look, different today. It's a good thing, I guess?
Honestly, I don't really know.
You see my head upside down from like the back of the carriage, and also calling the another person you had like a something, as that was quite a something indeed. What was that?
Easy there, Checker. Keep it on the road here.
Well, I went to it's this thing called the Mind Palace. Well, at least that's what I called mine. There, I found a different me. She told me that I had to do this awful test, and I had an hour to complete it. I lost, and then she took over my body.
Is that gonna happen, like, every day?
I really hope not.
It better not.
What do we do if you fail again? Do we, like, knock you out? Or is there a way to, like, get you back?
I...
Do we turn you off and on again?
How would you do that?
There's a joke in there. Somewhere.
Reset.
I only know how to turn her off.
Yeah, there it is.
Yep, there we go.
Okay, I'm gonna do something bad.
I want you guys to know every time I make a joke like that, I do finger guns at the voice channel.
Yeah, we know.
I kind of had a feeling.
I could feel it.
I want to ask the Codex, how do I, like, not, like, how do I deal with,
how do I kill her?
Not kill her, because I'm pretty sure it's me.
The Codex recommends a therapist. So what are you asking?
Like, how do they bring me back if I, you know, get fucked up? Well, locked in my head again or something, I don't know.
Make a wisdom check. If this happens again, just kind of have to let it ride through.
Okay.
It basically says,
you made a transaction the last time this happened, and you paid the consequences of it. If it happens again, then it's a transaction that you made. You agreed to it.
You're thinking a lot in your head there.
Okay, I'm about to like utter a curse word and then I'll stop myself. And I'll say, we can't do anything.
So we gotta just deal with Dark Poppy? You pop?
I guess so.
Yeah. And I'll go back to... I'll see my upside down go back up to the top of the caravan again.
So it's about a few hours into your journey at this point. That's about 2 weeks to Tormelis. As you're kind of riding along, Sanox will look at you, Lucia. And say, so Poppy,
I'm covering his mouth. I'm covering his mouth.
Huh?
Something happened? What's going on back there?
Nothing happened.
Sanox started talking, and then all of a sudden I heard a murf, 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 murf.
As that happens, you guys, those of you with a perception of passive perception of 13 or higher,
let's go!
You hear a commotion coming to the left of the main road you're traveling down.
I look to the left of the main road from like my cross-legged on top of.
You just hear the noise. Sounds like a scuffle or something.
Yo, Nildred.
Yeah,
pump the brakes.
I'll pull back on the reins and you know, stop the carriage.
Eat that horse.
No.
I'll jump from the top of the carriage. It's like there's a scuffle. I'm bored. I'm gonna investigate.
All right. So you just take off into the woods on your own.
I say that. I'll just start walking.
What about the rest of you?
Trust them alone.
With my hands still covering Sonox's mouth, I'm going to like put my nose against his. I'm gonna stare at him like I'm trying to be as intimidating as possible. Say, you will not utter a single word about what I said.
I'll think of that.
We're like, oh, think of it.
So what's the scuffle sound like? Is it like
he licks your
wood
hand.
On wood?
Wow.
Bear. Wolf on wolf.
Alright, so as...
There's a man being mauled to death.
As those of you who are going go, and Zenox will go as well, and he's no longer carrying you, Bobby.
Depression.
Yeah.
I'm jumping on his back. Like a monkey.
He just got a, like...
That's fine, I'll hold on.
He's so light is out.
That he doesn't, like, even react.
Like Pikachu on Ash's shoulder.
Pretty much.
Alright, let's...
Nether light is out. You guys keep hearing the weirdest shit out there. Uh-oh. Theme music!
You come to this clearing and you see a man, weapon out, running and doing battle with an ogre.
Oh, fuck.
Just
an ogre?
Yes. He is the ogre. The man's kind of scuffed up a bit, but the ogre's looking much worse. And you watch as the man runs up and beheads this ogre.
Oh!
With a nice little move. Well fought.
Yeah.
Shit, I forget what fucking she says.
So he's beheaded an ogre.
He beheads an ogre.
Oh boy.
Stands up.
There we go.
Wipes the blood away on the ogre, and he looks at you. Seth, would you like to introduce your character?
Yeah. A human, about 6.5, just under feet tall. Short blonde hair, short blonde beard as well. Is wearing plate armor, but the three most distinct features are his face that has scars all over it. Looks like a beast. And his cloak is a bearskin, like shimmering pristine cloak. And the weapon he used to behead the ogre is just a very large tree trunk. With,
and when I say behead, it basically knocks his head off.
Like a baseball bat.
Yeah. A bit of a divine glow to it as well when he did that, probably.
Hello. Well done.
Hi.
I've never seen someone take a head off of something with a tree before.
You just have to hit it hard enough.
I'm gonna pull on Senox's sleeve and I'll say, I'm scared of him.
So you reach around him?
Yeah.
From his back to pull on his sleeve?
I guess I'll pull on his collar. Sure. Yeah. That's better.
what you fighting ogres in the woods for? Were you attacked?
Yeah, it was on the way. Didn't want anyone to get jumped by it, so I might as well handle it.
Well, we probably would have been jumped by it. Would we have been jumped by it?
Probably.
Knowing us, probably.
Are there any more?
I don't know.
Survival check.
Mega survival check.
Just 10 surrounding us already.
And they're closing in.
You just 15.
They're giants this time. No, it doesn't appear to be any signs of other ogre activity.
I think we're in the clear. Well met, friend. How you doing? Mildred.
Oh. Pleasure. Leo. And I'll put a hand out.
Leo. I'll shake his hand. Okay, this is... Oh, there's the picture. Here, let me go ahead and put that up here for everybody to see real quick. Oh. See, You're also in the business of, killing things.
Please take general for my new gift, everyone.
Oh, for the love of...
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hell, this is exactly what's happening. Well done.
Yep. I'll take it.
Yeah, you know, any manner of monstrosities and demons.
Yes. Better watch out there, Mildred. I'm gonna get you.
What? We killed a dragon. And moreover, exactly. And I'm gonna, moreover,
that
he's gonna have
monsters.
He gestures to the big old pelt that's around his waist. I've killed direwolves before. Not a big deal.
Learned that for Seth gets bored, and on his characters, he rapidly switches between core, bio, and spells.
I
just had it open and I see it flashing again.
Yeah, you'll see that quite often.
That's funny.
So Leo, where are you headed?
Oh, nowhere in particular. Wherever destiny takes me.
Destiny.
Hi, my name's Destiny. You want to come with us?
Your name is not Destiny.
Whoa.
It could be.
That sounded awfully like you were hitting on him.
Whoa!
That was smooth.
Lucia in character goes, whoa!
Please take me to tavern first.
Oh my god!
There's probably taverns on the way.
So you killed a dragon?
Yeah.
Want to see its head?
Yeah.
The cat girl with a little bit of swag?
She is a sailor. She is a sailor.
Near you.
No. Oh, so we're heading to the show the dragon.
Yeah, we'll show him the.
Also, do we need to do anything about the now like bleeding from the head, empty ogre on the? Is it just gonna just sit there?
I mean, wolves or something will come eat it, right?
Honestly, their meat is terrible. You don't want to eat it, anything like that.
Yeah, the smell is horrendous. By the way,
should we like bury it?
I'd burn it, honestly. But I don't have any fire abilities here. We'd have to set a bonfire.
I'll try shooting it with Firebolt.
Impacts with a body with a thud. Burns the side a bit, but then goes out because it's just a cantrip.
That's
the best I got.
Hold on, yeah, I have a spell for this.
You could, like,
bonfire?
Twigs and branches. Maybe that tree that he took the head off with it for.
I blow it up.
Oh god, now it's everywhere.
Yeah, it just fucking explodes in the fire and rains down bits of gore on all of you.
Lucia.
You're welcome.
I think we could have left it though.
Poppy, you're fine because you're on the back of Setons.
I wanted to get rid of it. I got rid of it.
Yeah, you got rid of it on us.
You didn't say how. You just said you wanted it gone.
Did you catch Thelia's random?
Huh?
I shake like a cat and try to get the blood and gore off me.
Tenox will just kind of pinch his neck.
Well, I guess that's taken care of. It's now everywhere, and that's now much more of a pain in the butt to clean. Leaving it.
Ungrateful.
Just leave it.
Was it?
Yep.
Thank you for trying.
Glow. Yes. You cleaned up Poppy last night. Is there any way you can do that for the rest of us?
Get in a line. Each person comes up to me. I just prestidigitate everything away.
Thanks.
Well, that's useful.
Very. Wish we had this a while back.
You prestidigitationize me, and I pat you on the head because I'm really fucking tall. I'm 6'1". I'm super fucking tall. And I pat you on the head and go, thanks!
Yeah. She, like, does an awkward, like, one thumb high five. One thumb, like, yeah, hands don't hand.
Good job indeed. Here, no good is 6'9". He's probably the tallest in the group at the moment. So,
yo, my girl's short. Apparently,
I think we're all short. I think we're like, what, 5'6"?
Nakina, Thelia. And Poppy are the shorter of the group here, from what I remember.
Yeah. How tall is Glau?
5'6".
Hey, same height. We are our sisters.
I'm over here just fucking wiping my eyes. 5'6" isn't that short,
dude.
Are you 5'6"?
Yeah,
5'8".
In real life.
In real life, he's shorter than me.
In real life, like that.
In real life, he's shorter than me.
I love a short king.
He's like Webb. He's short.
I'm taller than my girlfriend. That's what matters to me.
You're taller than me.
You got lucky.
I am the second shortest person in my family.
And my taller than me!
My mom is 5'2", and my sister is, like, almost 6 feet.
Jesus Christ.
My grandpa was over 6 feet tall.
My mother is, like, 4'9", 4'10", I think.
Ugh.
So I'm a giant compared to her.
Hey, like, all my younger cousin, who is, like, 7 years younger than me, is taller than me. And it hurts.
Anyway. We gotta move
moving on.
So, Leo, you're coming with us then?
Well, love to see the dragon.
Alright, so cool. They all lead you back to this dragon? Bright pink carriage with a dragon skull that has no color because of the skull.
Oh yeah, it's a skull, right.
But let's all take this lesson to heart. On the inside, we're all the same. Color doesn't matter.
That's a quite a look. It's like we skinned the dragon and put the head on it, and it's like all pink on the outside, just a skull head. It's like random spots of blood on it.
It's
Could I use prestidigitation to make the skull like the same pink as the cart? It only lasts for an hour.
Yeah, you can make it pink for an hour.
Well, yeah.
Let's look at the limits of prestidigitation, shall we?
I'm reading it now, and it says, you make a color, a small mark, or a symbol appear on an object or surface for 1 hour.
I guess a skull would be an object.
Or a surface, technically.
I mean, depending on the skull.
I don't think it would cover the whole skull.
You can use it three times.
You can do little patterns.
So you can cover it in 3 instances of it.
You can make splotches of pink on the skull.
I will make like arterial blood spray pattern in the pink.
Okay.
So you're talking about blood earlier. Yeah.
That's really funny.
It works.
I'll say that with the new addition of Leo, there is not enough room in the carriage for all of you.
I am sitting on the top.
Yeah,
at all times.
Mm-hmm.
Thalia is on top.
I usually ride up front with Nildred,
I'm surprised you're not in the back making sure they don't do any hanky panky back there.
What is its name?
Well, whose name? If you're all able to kill a dragon, you might be what I've been looking for. A group of mighty heroes to fight fate and, you know, find destiny and whatnot.
Fate.
Well, don't worry, I'm a god, so we can do that.
Gods damn it.
You're a god?
I'm a god.
You're not a god. You're a demigod.
Are we all like children of gods?
But my dad was a demigod.
Don't look at me. I don't know.
You're a demigod too?
No, I think that's a bit of a grandchild. Vanthros.
Okay.
So you're a demigod.
Pull
out the amulet.
Vanthros.
Sorry, Jordan's crazy about that man.
Victory, glory, conquering.
He's my grandpappy.
My grandpappy.
You had to say grandpappy.
Side note.
I feel like the second one down.
Side note, for a bit of amusement for you guys. Seth originally wanted to name his character Theo, and I said you'd get memed pretty hard if you named him Theo.
Yes. Yep. Theo, stop it!
Theodore!
So I went for Leo. I changed it a lot.
L-E-H. And made an L.
Well, still have more to cover today. So, if you guys like, we can move on.
Please do.
If you,
He wants to sit up on top of me.
Nah, you're...
I can sit up top.
Leo if will I fall do a off, whistle. I can just... And call out for his horse, Maximus. So,
at the same time, Neff and I and Leo.
Neff. Who's Neff?
Neff. That is... Neff is not here. Different game.
Oh, sorry. Nakina.
Nakina!
Fucking Belissa. You and the new guy summon spectral steeds. Or phantom steeds, sorry.
Yeah.
I want to note, these last for an hour.
I did. Ooh, no. I just got excited that I even had one thing that kind of applied to something, okay?
Mine is an actual steed that just stays till it dies.
Zakina's is definitely a unicorn.
Yeah.
Yours stays.
I'm looking at the picture.
Young Blitz. Yours, spirit.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't read that part.
Okay.
But he, with him on a horse, you still fit in the gear, so.
I just got excited, okay?
That's fine. So for an hour, you have to ride a unicorn.
Yeah, well, maybe. Anyway, continuing on.
Alright. Anything you guys want to do? Like make camp for the night, or a talk, or do you want to just skip ahead to when you get to the Tormelos?
We still got a few. We've got a few days before we get there.
Like a week, you said.
Yeah, 2 weeks in total to get there. So, do y'all want to skip ahead till you get there, or
does anything exciting happen on the road?
Nope.
You don't have anything excited planned. Okay.
You fight off a few wolves and some bandits.
Yes, classic. We do the montage.
Yeah.
One guy.
Explosion.
Guy's head into a wolf. And, like, stomp its head, and it just cuts the guy's head off.
The entire journey, Senox needs to be holding something over Poppy. That she gets super embarrassed about.
At one point,
Well, Senox, we're gonna have watch at some point together, right?
Yeah.
You can tell me then.
Alright, so, what were you saying?
Chelsea. At one point, I get bored again, and I decide to fly for a little bit, and I fall out of the sky again. But I save myself.
I keep trying to catch you every single time.
Every single time, I just use Gust and Featherfall to just land right next to you.
The wings do not work, though. They're just for show.
Yeah.
These wings are vestigial.
Oh, wait, I like Sierra's.
Ayo, what?
I just had some
sent me pretty pictures of unicorns.
I'm really good at this shit.
So, after
a small talk on the way,
2 weeks of traveling, a lot of small talk, a lot of making fun of Poppy, some time on the horse for Nakina. You finally make it to the very small town of Tormelos. It is indeed a very small town, only maybe a couple hundred people. Not much to see. It's like there's an inn, a guardhouse. That's about it. Farming.
Was it like,
if anything?
Is it gate? Is it like a gate wall or anything like that? Or is it just like open?
Seems to just be open.
All right. We're here. I was told to find a man trapped in his head. What the fuck does that even mean?
I'm looking
you tell me.
Of destiny?
Should we just start busting down doors and seeing anyone slack jawed in their chair? Is there like a tower? I mean, like, is there like a wizard tower?
Doesn't seem like it.
I've been so much nicer if there was like a wizard tower. That'd probably be where it is.
You could always just go ask at a tavern here or wherever the locals gather.
Or you just like open up random doors to people's houses, like NPCs. And
you do that, and I'm just tying your tail to the wagon.
Take rupees.
I'm tying your tail to the wagon.
Illegal.
Illegal.
It's not illegal if you don't get caught.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm
oh, we are this sisters. Way. This is amazing.
I'm tying. I'm okay, tying your tail get to the wagon, and I'm tying your foot to the wagon.
I get to a tavern and let's first check to see if your aunt and pa are here, or well, if there's any more, you know, wanted posters or anything.
I mean, missing. My dad doesn't really matter.
No.
Wow.
I mean, yeah.
Can but relate.
I never met him. He like.
Oh right, I forgot about that.
My mom like football threw me at him, and he just kind of sidestepped, and my aunt caught me. That was the kind of interaction.
Anyone listen to the Percy Jackson musical?
Yeah.
No, nope.
Turns out, that shit.
Turns out your deadbeat dad's a deadbeat god.
Moving along.
All right, so what are you guys doing?
I'll hitch up the horses at the local stable.
Okay.
And join everybody in the search for the pub.
Alright. In it's pretty easy to find. Not very busy. It's like a few townspeople getting an early drink after hard day's work in the fields. It's about 4 or 5 in the afternoon now.
Is there a temple?
Just going down. Doesn't seem to be a temple, no.
Oh, these poor heretics.
They're not heretics. They're just poor. And they might have a shrine somewhere if you look for it.
Well, she did say these poor heretics.
Mm-hmm.
So, covered both bases.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Is there like another message board or bounty board or Craigslist on the wall again? Oh. Nothing to find on the walls. I'll go to the barkeep. I walk over towards whoever is keeping the bar.
We are not.
Yeah, this seems to be an older human gentleman wiping it out of glass, as all barkeepers do.
I kind of just approach. And just like, so, I'm looking for a guy, allegedly probably mentally trapped in his own head or something like that. You know, I didn't hear anything about any either like crazy people trapped in their head or someone in a coma.
You mean the sleeping man?
Really what you mean, call
that's
him?
That's, yeah.
Well, we call him Oliver, but.
Yeah, Molliver?
Oliver.
We call him Oliver, so.
Okay, yeah, Oliver, that's it. Where is he?
I mean, the mayor keeps him in his house.
Where in his house?
In a bedroom.
Okay. Sorry. Just checking.
I'm not with them here. I just need a drink and a room.
Where's the mayor's house?
You folks are definitely not from around here. Can I ask what you're searching for him for?
The sleeping man.
I was told to look for a man trapped in his mind by my mother. So that is what I'm here for. And I don't know what after that.
I'm looking for someone called the Prophet of Destiny.
I'm not here for that.
Yeah, what I am, you know.
Anything to go on besides that?
No, literally nothing. It's kind of inconvenient, I know.
Well.
Who knows? Oliver could be the prophet.
As strange as you all are, you're not the strangest person to roll into town today.
Can I just get a
Lady. She's kind of off-putting, to be honest with you.
Like, in a good way or in a bad way?
In a kind of creepy way.
What is she?
Talks to herself.
What's she look like?
He rented one of the rooms. It's, well, you know, like, I keep a little, I call them cabanas. She rented out one of those.
Welcome to Copacabana.
Can I just get a room and a drink?
Well, can I interest you in sort of Tromelos tamales?
Yeah.
Trust me, it's good. It's good. Yeah, we'll take those.
Okay. He serves up, after some time, some drinks, just regular ale, and these delicious tamales.
Really thought it would be margaritas, you know?
Tormelo tamales.
A martini.
Tormelos tamales.
Now,
enjoy.
Thank you, thank you. Trust me.
Here, Tormelo's tequila. You missed out.
Here. That's not a thing.
Here. You peel it like this, and then you eat the inside.
Like this? Banana.
You just ate the corn husk.
I did.
Are we not supposed to eat the whole thing?
No.
She's an empty plate in front of Leo.
Well, good luck later tonight here when that decides to make its way through your system.
That's okay, I'm magic.
Sanox will kind of nudge you, Poppy. Say, you want to go check out the creepy lady? Anybody want to come?
Scary, I mean, though. I want to check on a creepy lady.
I mean, yeah,
I
want
to check on
you know what?
To check on the creepy lady.
Yes.
As
much as I would love to say I'd like to check out this creepy lady, I can't let Thelia go on her own here.
How about we all?
I'm just gonna go visit a comatose person.
How about we all go see the lady and then we'll head towards the mayor's house
afterwards. Yeah, sounds like a plan.
I feel like that's a good idea.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm sure a whole bunch of random strangers showing up at her door is not going to freak her out.
In the evening.
Shit. So, you all make your way out to the cabana that the innkeeper pointed you out. And as you get to the door, get some music going here.
She's just banging with her Bluetooth speaker.
The door, which was closed, just slowly starts to creak open on its own.
Oh no.
I take it back. Maybe this
I immediately cast
the
mage armor. I'm not taking chances.
Hey, look, the door's open. I open it.
Seems to be dark inside, but you do hear what sounds like the conversation deeper in. Murmured voice.
Anyone got a light?
Oh, yeah, hold on. I'm sure I glow.
I glow.
My whole thing is sunlight. do I literally have anything?
You remember you do give off a faint glow in dark places.
I do just yeah. I do I go, oh hold on, and I'm just glowing.
Thank you, Poppy.
So, do you go further in?
Yeah. Let's go ahead and do this.
You go further in. Pull up my notes here. You go further in, and you find at a table a strikingly beautiful woman. And there are candles lit. And it almost looks kind of like a crypt, the way she has it set up. And she's humming to herself and playing cards, seemingly by herself, but randomly she says something to someone who appears not to be there.
I will push Lucia forward, since this is her mission. Oh.
We don't know this is my mission.
It could be the prophet.
I mean, maybe.
Adelaide. I mean,
she's got like tarot cards and everything.
People have entered your home.
I'm sorry, who?
What?
Huh?
I'm
confused.
Adeline? Is that like the, like Caroline? Like the claymation?
That's Coraline.
There you go. See, I already told you it was bad at
Adeline,
names.
Adeline, what do you do? You cut out.
I think I'll just throw a little wave. But that's it. Focusing on my cards for now.
Did you point post what they see?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Adeline.
And I want to, from what you guys see, the crown or tiara or whatever she has on her head, it is made out of bones.
Awesome.
I'm trying to put that up right now. Here we go.
So you're just playing with cards on a table?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's not creepy at all.
Look, you're going to look or I'm going to look? We can both look.
I got it. excuse me. Are you... Question, this could be weird. Are you the prophet of destiny?
Without turning her head... She'll, like, turning it towards you, I should say. So it's like she's still facing the cards, but her head will tilt to the side, kind of robotically. Or, it's almost like she's untethered to her movements. They seem forced. I've never heard of Prophet of Destiny. What is that?
I... was told to seek out the Prophet of Destiny in a vision I had, and I thought maybe that was you, but maybe not.
Prophet of Destiny sounds like something from godhood. Yeah, I hate the gods.
I very, very suspiciously side-eye Thelia and Glau.
You hear me, like, you see me, like, gasping with my hand in front of my mouth.
I don't move, but it's like I'm struggling not to, and my eyes just go... just go right over.
She'll, like, you know, do a little small giggle. And her hand will put a card down in front of, like, a pile of, you know, like a discard pile. And she'll say... It's okay, Brutus. It won't hurt me.
Brutus?
Who's...
Where's Brutus? Brutus sounds scary, to be honest.
He's
Do I see a Brutus in the room?
No, you God. Don't
oh,
anything.
Oh, is that the... Oh, who you're speaking to. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't know what to do.
I mean, so it's not, are you a prophet of something? Or a prophet? Or are you just destiny? Anything? I mean, you got some tarot cards, typically like some prophetic?
Prophetic.
Prophetic stuff, right?
Don't seem to be tarot cards.
Yeah, no, they're just like playing cards. Yeah.
Oh, playing cards. I thought I heard you say tarot cards.
You didn't.
No, I mean I heard you. I thought I heard you say it, so I did think that. But I didn't you didn't say it.
Do you need people to play a game with?
I have people to play game with.
Except for some games, like more the merrier.
Alright.
Come sit.
Is this then. Is this like a poppy situation? You have some people in your head?
They're not in my head. My name is Eddie, but
You may call me Miss Fort.
Not creepy at all.
Oh, and you get the sense that she made a joke. But it was just, like, really shittily delivered. Like, it's not like, Miss Fortune, it's like misfortune, it's like the word. Like, get it.
Is it Ms. Are you going to give us a fortune or something? Is it Ms.?
Or like Xenox will look MS down at Poppy, expecting her to be, like, shaking in her boots.
Oh, yeah, she totally is. She's like, who the hell is this bitch? Somebody, like, crawled out of hell and I'm not here for it.
Yeah. Adeline, you recognize this Poppy.
This.
From a description you received.
Okay. She'll, like, move her leg to push a chair out for one of them. Doesn't really matter who.
I mean, if no one else is dumb enough to throw their life away, I am. I'll take it.
I was gonna say pushes Thalia forward.
Mm-hmm. We should step together forward. All right, at the same time. We're playing, like... I'm just like.
I'll play blackjack, 21, poker, go fish.
Things in the corner. Just hold them.
51 pickup. There's a 52.
Gin rummy.
We were playing a game that Crash. I invented. Is it play on catch 22?
Do we have, like...
I sent you a name for a game, Jordan.
Let her explain.
21, 22 cards, and do you, like, throw cards in the air and we gotta catch them?
The saying alludes that no matter what choice you make is bad. Okay. We're all losers here.
Some of us more than others.
Bit harsh.
I was talking about me.
Brutus likes to say the game is called Dead Man's Gambit. But I do not make bets. I simply choose a card and he kicks my ass.
So you're saying Brutus is really good at the game?
Oh, yes.
Oh, can I get Brutus on my team? Or is it like a 1v1 sort of situation?
I will lose anyway. You may have team.
Ah, sweet.
I will be right.
All
right,
buddy. Let's go, Brutus. Where you are? Are there chairs around this table?
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna pull one next to me and pull it out. I got Brutus next to me.
You'll see that her eyes will track the chair that was across from her. Like, her eyes will lift as if she's watching said Brutus walk over to that chair and sit down next to you.
Awesome. So how do we play? What's the deal? You just pick a card? Any card? Or is it, like, a deal of cards? Like, what's the...
She'll flick her wrist, and the discard pile will start to, like, shuffle and on its own. And then you'll get 5 cards, and she'll say,
"You must pick one card. If my card is more than yours, I get a point. If it is less... you get a point."
Okay.
Just truly simple.
So, I just pick one of my cards. How many cards? 10, 13. I pick a 4 out of my 5 cards. And I place it down on the table. So it's like a...
I guess I'll just do what you did.
Yeah. 1d13, because I think he's adding. Yeah. One moment.
Well, that's the wrong character, but you get it. You get the point. Here, I'll do it for... What?
I get a point? Or you get a point?
Brutus wins.
Makes sense. Fuck. Tracks.
Yeah, you just said he wins.
Yeah. She'll laugh. And there's like real affection and like mirth in her tone. And she'll say, "See, I told you. All he does is win."
Man, you are right. Are there like rounds? How long do we go?
Usually until I tire.
Well, so you can like go all day with this.
Until I rise the next morning.
Well, I'll like fold the rest of the 4 cards in my hand and place it into the discard pile. It was at least fun to play at one game, but I do have other stuff I gotta do. It was nice meeting you and Brutus. Lucia, because you know, I read your name as Lucio.
Lucia.
I know, it's a fucking problem. I mean, she says she's not your prophet, unless you're some kind of like fortune teller, or you got anything to go off of, or unless, I don't know, whoever told you to find it, if you can ask them again. Be more specific.
Unfortunately, I feel as though I might be required to join your party.
No more.
Crap.
I mean, I'd love to have Brutus with us.
Josh!
You guys are just picking us up left and right.
Look, yeah. This is the first time that this has happened. I don't know what happened. Why are we getting so many people?
I don't think we can fit Brutus into our cart.
No. Wait.
She snaps her fingers and smiles.
He's in my dimension now. Gone.
I don't know if...
Brain space?
I am... You know what? Two of you end up riding on the roof of the carriage anyhow here. We have one extra spot, ma'am. If you want to join us, sure. We leave whenever these two idiots find what they're looking for here.
Hey, man, who knows? Oliver could be joining us.
Have I done something wrong for you?
She's asking you, Nildred.
I don't think you've done anything wrong, per se. I've just been having a bad week. I'm still trying to get over a few things.
Which, Nildred, I would say that every night you and Senox have a little sparring session.
Okay.
So you've been sore every day this past 2 weeks.
Not only...
End on that sometime.
Let me put it to you this way.
You're on a bit.
You know what? You're welcome to ask him. Look. A lot of shit has happened.
Perhaps it would make you feel better if I told you my purpose for joining your party. You see, Someone told me to look out for the little Lunari back there. The headmaster. My boss.
Look back at Poppy. Look back at Adeline. So this is mostly for business then.
I call him my boss, but it is a loose term. More or less, he asked me a favor, and I owe a great deal to him. I would do what he asked of me.
I suppose that is fair.
Why does he want you to look after Poppy? This is Senox asking. He's kind of tucking Poppy behind him. If she isn't already hiding back there.
Oh, she totally would be.
It was a request from her father.
I'll kind of look back at Poppy.
Yep, same for Mildred.
Poppy will take her hand and, like, shove Senox down to her, you know, shit, like, eye level, you know?
Down 3 feet.
Yeah. and she'll say, she's talking about Elyon.
How would she know your dad?
Don't know.
Ask her.
I get the feeling somebody's got some questions.
Cool. But I'm put my DM hat on and talk to myself.
Yep.
There you go.
One of two characters. That's what you get.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so Poppy will... She'll probably have to take, like, a couple minutes to... Because she's, like, genuinely kind of, like really afraid. Huh? Yeah, she's, like, really afraid of this woman. And she'll look to the party as a whole before, you know, tracking her gaze back to Adeline. And she will address pretty much everyone in the room. And say, my dad is... Elyon, you know, the one and only god of magic.
I was going to say, please.
Why does this keep happening?
I would like to know that as well here. We've got three so-called demigods.
I mean so-called.
I say so-called for you two here. I believe Poppy, because she hasn't lied to me. I think.
I don't lie to you.
I don't lie, Mildred. Even if I tried, I think it would be horrible. Absolutely just abysmal. I can't keep a straight face.
So, how do you know... her father.
Adeline looks furious.
it's like a bad romance.
God damn it. Caught in a bad romance.
Oh my god, she's so mad. Especially finding out this way is like ridiculous.
Oh shit.
You will be tucked back behind Senox.
Hand slowly raising to the sword.
She'll look to all of you and she'll say, children of God.
What?
missed that. I'm sorry.
It said children of God?
Yeah. Got one right here.
Yeah.
And you're not a back. You're not exactly thrilled. That's right. You said you hate the gods. Not all of us can control whom we are born by, apparently.
You can hate me, but I can love you. That's all that matters.
I lean over to Nakina. Oh, that's a different. Is that a different game? No. I think they're in love.
Absolutely.
I am not so vain as to hate an offspring of a god. What I dislike is that the god who asked me to take care of this Lunari never told me he was god.
Sounds like a real scumbag. Sorry, god. No offense.
Poppy will, like, step on your foot.
You hurt your foot again.
Poppy, you gotta use more heal.
She'll do that she now.
She just... Mildred, she just can't put the proper force behind it.
How about... At least she's not healing you, overhealing you every time she strikes you.
Go for the axe kick next time. It's effective.
Well, especially if you're still in that skirt. And you do it. Look, I get it. I think I get it now. You'll have to forgive me. I'm not as quick on the uptake as the others. So, the god, you were asked to do this by a god, and he didn't tell you he was a god.
That would be correct.
Does that mean you're going to abandon this altogether, or are you going to see it through?
Are you, like, contracted? You have no
I'm
choice.
Not contracted.
So really? Why did you agree to it in the first place?
Do you like him?
That does not matter.
Does he like him? Can I roll an insight check?
Yep, this is gonna end well.
11.
Poppy, you can whisper roll either a persuasion check or a deception check. Your choice.
For Adeline.
If it's, you know, you're lying, trying to hide it or
okay.
To
okay. Him what you're not. Okay. Okay.
Roll like a 2. Roll like a 2, please.
She spazzed.
Being honest. Like, you know, that doesn't matter. She doesn't like him. She seems, from the way she's acting, she seems pretty pissed at him.
Alright then. Then... If you intend to see through your mission, then welcome to the team.
How many more children of gods are there here?
Supposedly these two, and I'll point to Glau and Thelia.
Yeah, and then that one is your now guardianship over, and a grandchild? Does that count?
Yeah, my dad was a demigod. But...
How far did the
I forgot
god
about that.
Go down the pool?
I don't know. I have divine powers, so.
He's
a
legend.
So it's like, does it go like by Super Saiyan rules where you get stronger the more like the thinner the blood is?
The hell's a Super Saiyan?
It's me.
I know you have welcomed me to your team but I must admit something of myself before.
Are you a demigod?
No, I can't take much more of this here. Please tell me that's not...
She looks not... disgusted.
I look, like I got my eyes and my, like, my hands under my chin looking at you, like, expecting
yeah,
me.
Yeah, she says, over my dead body would I be a demigod.
Aw.
Seems like too much responsibility.
It's not the responsibility. It's the fact that the gods lie. They have no care for their creations.
I mean, you're not wrong.
Of course I'm not wrong. I've lived it.
So what was your truthful incantation before I interrupted you?
I am necromancer.
Oh.
Will this be a problem?
Yeah. I mean, kill people deliberately to get bones? Oh, other than like...
Most of you would know, while not outlawed, necromancy is very heavily frowned upon by most people. To magical people, it's frowned upon to, like, you know, normal townsfolk, that's the devil's work.
And, however, we do have a holy woman here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's
hello.
Right. You are kind of weird.
I'm a cleric.
Yeah, weird.
I don't have a problem with it, if that's what you were... Oh, wait a minute. I'm going to look over at Lucia.
You had a problem with me being a cleric?
No, I'm just more curious as to how you're going to take it.
Necromancy?
Yeah.
I don't know. I deal with, like, the sky and stuff, and the space and the planets. I don't really deal with the life and death thing. Like, yeah, I can heal you guys. But that's not really my wheelhouse, you know?
Fair.
I mean, like, I'll put down an undead. I believe in putting souls to rest, but, like, you know.
What about you, the tree trunk? I forgot your name, Leo.
Real quick, the I believe putting souls to rest is a hardcore line.
Putting souls to rest, yeah.
As long as you're doing something good with it. Like, probably fine.
Jeez, you're so good at making yourself seem not cool.
Me?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I said, oh man, she's just said a hardcore line, and then you post a picture of a fucking dancing elephant.
No, it's the elephant from Adventure Time. Her name is Tree Trunks.
Yeah, said tree yeah trunk. Because she said tree trunk.
These two things have nothing to do with each other.
<That's bad. laughs>
All right. Moving on.
I mean, necromancy's dope, you know? You get to, like, I mean, if we die, you can bring us back, right? Is that who Brutus is?
I could trap your soul in my dimension and keep you forever.
Yes. Does that mean I get to meet Brutus?
Indeed.
That sounds fun.
Don't be in a rush to die there, Thelia.
I ain't no rush to die. It's just, you know, if it happens, might as well be in a cool place.
I take the greatest affection in making sure that my family is safe.
I'm sending you a message.
Okay.
So then, we off to Sleepy Joe's?
With the love of... Who the hell is Sleepy Joe?
The Sleepy Man in the mayor's house.
For I have not eaten, and I do love a good goulash.
You're gonna have to convince the fella at the front.
Are you doing
front.
More puns on ghouls now? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
just pick up some sloppy joes at Sleepy Joe's.
I'm gonna get you.
Pretty much just gonna have like this Halloween character just making random like jokes. And
I'm getting you tamales, and you're gonna like them.
I have a bone to pick with him every time.
Yeah, that's literally gonna be her. don't worry about it. I have a full list of a whole ass doc of like puns and shit.
Oh God,
you ain't ready.
You guys want to know the joke I made when I first made a bard? Why did the skeleton lose the sense of humor? He lost his funny bone.
Get out.
You're mad at me for my Shriek Hunt reference.
Get him out of here.
Since the goulash one didn't go over well, she's gonna elbow Thalia and she'll say, I could really go for some corn on the macabre though. If you're not really into goulash.
I'm uncultured, I shouldn't know this.
Corn on the what?
Macabre.
Is that a... Okay.
Senas will lean down to Poppy and say, there's finally someone worse at making jokes than you are. Congratulations.
Oh, yada! She's gonna hit him. Just.
Oh, God, he's gonna do the little... She's gonna do the little... Ding, 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 ding.
Yeah.
Poppy the type of girl to wind up her arm before she punches someone.
Oh, fucking Popeye.
Why, yada.
Why, I...
Rip, bam, zoom, you.
Why, yada.
As you, start making our way towards the tavern. We're gonna go ahead and end the session there for tonight.
Golly gee.
I gotta go to bed. Or do yeah. Or something.
Man. So hopefully you all enjoyed.
No, I did.
For reference, if you look at the subchapters I did in the announcements, Setting Sail was for Glau. Mortal Kombat was for Leo, and Dead Sexy was for Abby.
Okay. Yeah. So
I was very proud of Dead Sexy.
Very good.
Told him that he should have did Drop Dead Gorgeous, but he was like, that's too on the nose.
Yeah. Drop Dead Lady!
I mean, I wouldn't have figured it out regardless.
Well, you're dumb, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, welcome, all you new players here, and I do hope any and everybody here who is watching this enjoyed this as well as we did making all this chaos. Bye, everybody!
Yay!
There are now 9 people in the party.
That's so many people.